Hello friends, in this video we are going to find how can we are going to calculate how can we find shear force and bending momentum at any internal point. Suppose let me start from this example. Determine the internal shear and momentum acting in the cantilever beam shown at the section passing through the point C and D. So I have to find bending momentum and shear force at point C and point D. So let me start. First I will find shear force and bending momentum at point C. So I have to draw free body diagram for this section. Let I take this as A and this B. I have to draw free body diagram for C and B section. Let me start. This is C and this is B. Sorry, here is also 20 kilonewton meter. This is given bending momentum, so I will write here one force 5 kilonewton and another 5 kilonewton. This is 1 meter. This point is very close to this force, so this distance is 1 meter, and here is bending momentum 20 kilonewton meter. I will take this direction momentum at C, and this is a fixed support because this beam is continuous. I am breaking this section B and C, so this will be a fixed support. So this will give three reactions. One is bending momentum and another vertical force. I will write it as VC, vertical force at C, and horizontal force. I will write it as horizontal force at C. So if you find momentum MC, if it comes out to be negative, suppose minus 50, and this means you are assuming directions wrong, you have to change your direction. Let me first to find and so let me find first. Let me first use this equation. Summation of momentum at point C is 0. So when we are calculating this shear force or bending momentum at any internal point, we have to choose only one direction. You can go through this direction or you can go through this direction. I am using this section because it is more easy. So I draw free body diagram of this section. Now I will use this equation. Summation of momentum at point C is 0. So it will be, due to this, it is positive MC because it is trying to rotate beam in upward direction. Minus momentum due to this, and this is negative, minus 5 into 1 because this is in downward direction, and minus 5 into this distance is 2, and this is minus 5 into this distance is 3. And this is given momentum 20 kilonewton meter. So this is in downward direction. This will try to move rotate beam in downward direction. This will be negative. So this is 0, which further implies I can write MC equals to 50 kilonewton meter. So it means our assumed direction is correct because this comes out to be positive. If it will be negative, then it means our assumed direction is wrong. So momentum at point C is 50 kilonewton meter. Let me find now vertical force at point C. So I can use this equation. Summation of vertical forces at point C is equal to 0. I will write it as Y, vertical force. So I can write one vertical force is VC. I will treat upward direction as positive, minus downward force is minus 5 and minus 5. There are only four forces, one upward direction, in upward direction, and three are in downward direction. So summation will be 0, which further implies VC will be 15 kilonewton. Now let me find horizontal forces. I will use this equation. Summation of horizontal forces equals to 0. So here is one horizontal force HC. I will take this direction as positive, and there is no any horizontal force, so I will write minus 0 will be 0, so which further implies horizontal force at C will be 0. So SC is 0. Now we have to find momentum and forces at point D. So let me start. First I have to draw a free body diagram for this. So I will draw free body diagram of section DB. I can calculate from this side also. I can draw free body diagram of section A and D, and I can calculate from this side, but it is more easy if we choose this side. So I will draw free body diagram for this. So here is 5 newton kilonewton force, another 5 kilonewton, and this another 5 kilonewton, and I have to include this 5 kilonewton because this is on right side. So this is 5 kilonewton, this is point D, and there is 20 kilonewton meter. This is given, this is 1 meter 1 meter 1 meter. So this is a fixed support because I am breaking here, so I have to write momentum at D. So because there will be three reactions, one will be momentum, one will be force, I will write dy. I will write dy for vertical force at point D, and horizontal force will be hd. Now I will use all these, I will use same equations. First what I have to do, I will first write summation of momentum at point D will be 0. So this will be md minus 5 into, this distance is 0, 0 minus 5 into 1 minus 5 into 2 and minus 5 into 3 and minus 20, this is given, which is equal to 0, which further implies md will be, momentum at point D will be 5 10 15 20, that is 20 30, that will be 50 kilonewton. So momentum at point D, sorry this is D, so momentum at point D is same as 50 kilonewton. Now let me find what will be the this vertical force at point D. So I can write summation of vertical forces at point D will be 0. So I can write this dy, this is in upward direction, minus 5, this is in downward direction, and this is in downward direction, minus 5 minus 5 minus 5, it will be 0, which further implies dy equals to 5 10 and 20, that is dy be 20 kilonewton. So our vertical force dy is 20 kilonewton. Now I have to find horizontal force hd. So I can write summation of horizontal forces at point D equals to 0. So horizontal force is hd here, hd, there is no any horizontal force in this member D and B. So I can write hd minus 0 equals to 0, which further implies horizontal force at point D equals to 0. So this is very simple. Hope you understood this. Thanks. Have a nice day.